Yes, sir, I am on a carpeted ping pong table right here. This is beautiful. They went all out on us, so it's really nice. I can't believe this is weird in Florida. I'm from New York. Give it up. Anybody else from New York? Oh, see? Because no one's born in Florida. I was telling her today what happened. The weirdest thing. Now, I'm like 1,500 miles from here, okay, my house. And it's such a small world. It really is amazing. And you guys know how this works. I'm 1,500 miles away from home. Earlier today, guess what? I run into another guy that spoke English. It was so weird. I was like, what are the odds? You know, that I felt so much better after that happened. I take my picture, lady. Hi, how are you? Good. So, how are you guys way back there? Good? How do you like it in the rear? Okay, that's nice. Keep the show rolling. So it is, we're going to have fun, man. It is great in Florida. Weird, though. Anything that's ever bizarre happens in Florida. I have noticed that. Whenever anything on the news comes out that is some stupid, bizarre freaking story, they always start out with, from Florida. Oh, my God. Now, I was only here like 2 weeks. Some guy threw an alligator through the window at the drive-thru window at Wendy's. Yes, a guy threw an alligator through the drive-thru window at Wendy's. I didn't believe it. I think it's a crock. Okay. All right, shut up, people. This is all I got, okay, people? So shut up. But it's great. I am from New York. We get a lot of snow. It's so nice to be where it's warm. We get a lot of snow where I live, a lot of snow. Even though, like, I travel a lot, I know we get a lot of snow at my house. Because whenever I'm on the road, I call home. My wife told me she was getting 8 inches every night, you know, while I'm on the road. So I know that we get a lot of snow. Thank God I have good neighbors. You know what I'm saying? No, stop. My one neighbor said he was plowing her like 3 times a day, you know, while I was away. Thought that was kind of nice of him. Stop it. I can go further. Bought my wife a brand new snow blower. She told me she was blowing the whole neighborhood while I was gone. All right, no more of those. We're just having fun, people. That's all. But we're all obsessed with the weather, though, right? Like yesterday. Now, I know you guys got some storms here. Woof, right? I'm with my dad in 4 miles, but no matter where you are, the world, we are obsessed with the weather. That's all anybody talks about, the weather. Holy shit, the weather. What about the weather? Goddamn weather. What about, and you can't tell anybody. You can't say it's a beautiful day today. You know what they say? Oh, yeah, but yesterday was, oh, shut up. I want to enjoy today. Oh, next week we're going to get it. We'll pay for it. That's awful. The weather, that's all anybody ever does. Even your local newscast down here. Imagine where it's shitty. 90-minute newscast, 88 minutes of it was weather. That's all they go. We're going to get a shot of the weather, then we're going to check the weather. Then we're going to look at the weather one more time. We're going to check the weather inside. We'll check the weather outside. And no matter what happens, that's the big story, right? You walk by the TV, breaking news. Space aliens have landed in Fort Myers. Holy shit. But first, let's get a shot of the weather, shall we? The weather guys are like all anal and shit. Woo! We got that super duper Doppler radar. He's like, we can zero in, man. We can tell you the weather right in your own backyard. It's not a weatherman, that's a stalker. Get the hell out of my yard. Then the guy's like, we're going to go to the map. We're going to show you the satellite of the previous 24 hours. Did anybody not catch that shit live? Or what are you guys calling up the TV? I talked to the weather guy. Yeah, it was about 3 o'clock today. That cold front came through. Son of a bitch, I was in the basement and I missed the whole goddamn thing. I forgot you guys don't have basements here.
No.
Sorry. Every once in a while, I forget where the hell I am, people, okay? Let's pretend we're in Alabama. Do they have basements in Alabama? I don't know. Then a guy tries to, I like when they pinpoint it though, right? Even down here, they'd be like, all right, Fort Myers, 72 degrees. Port Charlotte, 73. Bradenton, 74. Like somebody's going to go, honey, we should make the trip over to Bradenton, don't you think? But now they got this thing, Your News Now or News 10 Now. They do the weather every 10 minutes. Every 10 minutes for the rest of your goddamn life every 10 minutes. You should live where I live. That shitty town. Still shitty. Back to you, Bill. It's like 2 o'clock in the morning. Dark and shitty. Back to you. So I came to Florida. Oh my, I drove. Oh my God. Anybody driven down here through Florida? Oh, before I get to Florida, let me just tell you about the trip down here. Anybody here ever gone through Pennsylvania? Holy shit. Are you from Pennsylvania? Tell them to fix that goddamn road, will ya? That road's been under construction since I was 11 years old. Let me just tell you, here's what happened. There's a couple of guys that are, see, where I come from, you have to drive through the whole state of Pennsylvania. So there's a couple guys that work for the DPW and PA, and they're pissed because they don't like people just coming through their state, okay? So they're gonna get together and figure out how they can stop this. So the guys, all right, here's what we're gonna do. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put up 1,500 orange cones for no goddamn reason whatsoever. Now we're gonna put the potholes on the good sides of the cone. There you go, get over there, right? Now we're gonna send a couple of tractor trailers through there. Yeah, whip them through there, get them going, yeah. All right, now they get really pissed. So now you know what they do? They go, all right, now they're getting pissed, right? Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna put up those cement girders. You know what I'm talking about? All right, we're gonna actually take a tape measure of the width of your car and put it 1 inch on either side. You know, so you got a little way to go, a little room to go, okay? Now I want you to be following a truck that's spitting off rocks with a sign that says, do not follow, for 75 miles. Then you finally get through that. Now they're really pissed. They go, oh my God, the guy made it through there. Release the deer. There you go. You got no chance. No chance at all. So I got to Florida. Now, here I am in Florida. Oh, my God. First of all, the bugs. The bugs. Oh, my God. I checked into a hotel. A bug checked into the room next to me. Holy shit. Even the ants. Big, fat ants. Oh. And I'm Italian. I know about fat ants. I got here, though. I found out. Is this on? Can you guys hear me? Okay. Sorry about that. I'm losing my hand. I got here. I found out Florida is actually the home of old people and their parents. Holy shit! The first night I was in Orlando. The next night I went to Daytona, so I don't know. I go on to the GPS, it said from Orlando to Daytona was like 118 miles or something. And then next to that it said estimated time, 7.5 hours. Apparently they knew the old bastard I was gonna be behind the whole goddamn way there. So all I saw was hat and knuckles down Route 4. and what is this fascination recently with old people, old people wanting to do young things? Larry King, how the hell old is Larry? He's like 90, right, Larry King? He's got little kids. He was 80 years old, 80. His wife gave birth to his child at 80. Yes, imagine that. The baby came out, was 56 years old, holy shit. Poor little bastard having trouble with his prostate already. Can you imagine an 80-year-old guy with a baby? They could go through stages together. Yes, they both be drooling, both be wearing diapers, both be in a walker at the same time. It could happen. But then, now I read this just recently. I'm not making this up. A 66-year-old woman gave birth naturally. Oldest woman to give birth, 66. Yeah. Now, apparently, she wanted to breastfeed. The baby didn't want any part of it at all. How is a 66-year-old lady supposed to breastfeed? Put the baby on the floor? There you go, that's nice. Come on. Come on. Come on. I don't think she should breastfeed. I mean, at that age, the milk might be spoiled, am I right? Or powdered, one or the other, we don't know. Kids should have known the expiration date on the nipple was 1979. My whole life, I'm telling you. This whole thing, everything messes me up. It screws me up, I'm tired. I've been traveling around, doing a lot of clubs, colleges, casinos. Where's my gamblers? We got any gamblers in the house?
Yes.
Yeah, all right. They got a casino going up every 11 minutes, and there's no gamblers here. Right, okay. You a big gambler, lady? You like that? See, I went to that Indian place you got down, those Indian bastards. I lost $100 in the first machine I played. That was the ATM. Shit! But now here's what happened. I live way up north in New York, and they have an Indian casino up there, and I used to do shows every Wednesday, right? And they would get mad. They'd come up to me. They'd go, hey, please, no Native American jokes, because they don't want that. I said, okay, I'm good. I can do that. After a show, the guy came up to me, and he goes, hey, I'm Native American. You offended me. I said, I offended you? How? Yeah, you know, that's not, I did not know. That's... I said, I have my reservations about you too, sir, but I didn't want to. So, let's just bury the hatchet, shall we? So, I like pissed off the crowd right there. I could tell. Ship this guy back to me. So I've been to Vegas. Who's been to Vegas? Come on, Vegas, applaud. Where's Vegas? Who's been there? Sir, you ever been to Vegas? Oh, look at him. Yeah, right here. Hi, how are you? Good to see you. We're going to get... He thinks... B12. B12. Does he know where... You never been to Vegas? Have you ever been to Fort Myers? You ever been to Fort Myers? It's nice. It's real nice. It's no Naples, but you should check it out and get down that way. So listen up. Here's the deal. I'm going to give you a little theory about Vegas. Now, so I'm in Las Vegas, okay? I'm staying in a place called Mandalay Bay. Anybody familiar with that? Huge hotel. Now, yes, big, bigger than a hotel in Fort Myers. I know it just came for something. So, I'm not a big drinker. Okay, I don't think I'm against drinking. I mean, I drink, but I'm not a big drinker. But when you're Vegas, they want you to drink. Yes, they for that girl with a big boob. She stick them right in your face. I didn't know what I was doing. It was like a photo finish in a blimp race. Holy shit, look at that. Jeez. I was like, you can't argue with those 2 points, lady. I'm drinking. All right. So I don't know what I'm doing, right? I'm drinking a gamble, drinking a gamble, drinking a gamble, drinking a gamble. Bam. Now I'm shit-faced. I'm barreled. I don't know if I'm on foot or horseback. I am gone. But I'm winning. I'm up like $1,000 right now. Fort Myers guy, listen to me. In Vegas, it isn't like they just hand you $1,000. They give to you chips and bullshit, right? And you gotta walk from here to Orlando to cash it in, am I right? And I gotta go buy every possible way to lose my money. I got slot machines, blackjack, let it ride, two hookers, a guy with a tin cup. I just wanted to cash it in. I cashed it in, now I got $1,000, it's 4:30 in the morning and I am drunk as a skunk and I'm starving. Holy shit, I am hungry as a hostage right now. I gotta get something to eat. So here's what I did. Now, I don't recommend this for anybody, okay? I ordered room service. Yeah, yes, you know. They banged the shit. It was $19 for an order of toast. I go, does it come with butter? $22.50. Jesus Christ, all right. I don't give a shit. I got $1,000. I called and I said, give me a rumus sandwich, a bag of chips, and a Coke. Now the guy comes in, he wheels in, he's got flowers and candles, balloons and shit. Get the... I'm starving. Give me the bill. I get the bill. Holy shit. $82.10. $82.10 for a sandwich. I thought it was going to be like $50. I was going to punch the shit out of the guy. Now I got to act like a big wheel. Here's $100. Get out of here. $82.10. I couldn't even eat the sandwich. I'm rolling over. $82.10. I got up in the morning. I said, that's bullshit. There had to be a mistake. I looked at the bill again. Shit. I was staying in room 8210. Shit! The sandwich was $27.
That's a good one.
Gave that son of a bitch a $100 bill. Come knocking on my door. You need to go to Smithsburg? Screw you, little piece of shit. I'm telling you right now. Is it all right if I use your table? Thank you. I'll take everything off there but the check. So, yes, I'm telling him. A friend of mine, he's a midget. Good buddy of mine, little guy. Love him, midget. Get him. Are we good? All right. Are you sitting on your keys, lady? So I got a friend of mine. He's a midget. Are we going to, did I ever say that? Okay. Little guy. Really nice guy. Love him. Guess what, though? He told me a secret. He told me he was gay. Yeah. That was weird. After all these years, he finally came out of the cupboard. And we are just so happy for him. Oh, stop. I dated a midget girl once. That was weird. Yeah, we broke up. I was devastated, you know, because I was nuts over her. And, we dated 6 months before she went up on me, sir. I swear to God. All right, I'm sorry. That is as low as I will go, and I'm not doing another midget joke. You guys will throw me right out of Southport or wherever that, Northport. Sorry, I don't know. Directionally challenged. So, I'm married. Where's the married people? Come on, applaud. Married people here. Oh, yeah. Look at everybody so excited for me. Now, is anybody dating? Anybody dating here on the big date tonight? Who's that? What? Over here? Dating? No? Married? You're married.
Why not both?
What? Well, I guess, but I got to know which way to be funny about. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't prepared for somebody that was right down the middle.